Om Sahanavavatu, Sahanaubhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavadhi Tamastuma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om. We were seeing the commentary of Shankaracharya on the fifth sutra of the Brahma Sutras. Shankaracharya, page number 242. So Shankaracharya here talks about how this body-mind complex is produced because of ignorance, and the difference between a sansari or an individual soul who is subject to the cycle of transmigration and Ishvara, that sense of difference is produced because of false cognition. So this response is given by Shankaracharya because there is this objection by the opponent that you say, or the scriptures, Shruti say in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, that the seer or the knower is not separate from the ultimate reality. Then how can you say that the body-mind complex is there for a sansari, that is a soul which is undergoing transmigration, repeated birth and death, whereas it is not available, or which is not applicable to Ishvara? Because according to your philosophy, that is Advaita Vedanta, there is no difference between these two. Then Shankaracharya says that just like the space which is without any difference is limited by different shapes or different forms, like the pot, kamandalu, mountain, cave, etc. Similarly, because of the false understanding, because of the ignorance, nescience, we see that there is a mithya buddhi in the sense of identification with body-mind complex. Tatha ihapi dehadi sanghata upadhi sambandha aviveka krite krita ishvara samsari bheda mithya buddhihi. Because of aviveka, because of lack of discernment, because of lack of knowledge, and because of one's identification with the qualified existence of body-mind complex, one finds a difference between Ishvara and Sansari, which is Mithya Buddhihi, which is a false cognition, false understanding. Drishyate cha Atmana eva satah Devhadi sanghate anatmanya Atmatva abhinivesho Mithya Buddhi matrena Purva Purvena. Also, it has been seen in the past, or it has been seen across time, different periods, that because of false understanding, because of false knowledge, false cognition, dehadi sanghate anatmani atmatva abhiniveshaha. So, in the body-mind complex, which is anatma, which is not self, there is an identification of atman. So, then atman gets identified with the body-mind complex, which is anatma, so which is not self. And this we see because of mithya buddhi matrena, because of false cognition alone. Matrena means it is only because of false cognition. Sati chaivam sansaritve dehadi apeksham ikshitritvam upapannam sansarinah. And because this is So, this being the case, in the case of an individual soul who is a sansari, or who is subject to repeated birth and death, or who is subject to repeated lifetimes or transmigratory cycle of existence, which is called sansara, dehadi apeksham ikshitritvam upapannam samsarina. Samsarina, for a sansari or for a soul like this, which is falsely identifying itself with body, or which has got ignorance, means one who sees the soul from an ignorant standpoint, means because of ignorance. For that person, ikshitritvam, the power of seeing, is dehadi apeksham. It's dependent on body, etc. Body, etc. means body, mind, prana, etc. Because that soul is identified with the body. So because the soul is identified with the body, that body cannot see, or the soul cannot see without a body, without the instrument of a body. So it is upapannam, it is quite logical. It is because of ajnana, because of ignorance, that a soul thinks that the body is necessary, body, mind, prana, etc. is necessary, are necessary to see. Yadyapi uktam, as also it has been told, pradhanasya anekatmakatvat mridadivat karanatva upapattihi na asahatasya brahmana iti. See, mridadivat, just like clay, etc. Clay, etc. means clay, metal, anything, matter like that. Pradhanasya anekatmakatvat. Just like clay can, clay, etc., or material like clay, etc., can take different forms, pradhana also, which can take different forms. Anekatmakatvat. It can have different manifestations. So it is why it is told karanatva upapattihi. It has been told that it is the, this is actually an objection. This is an objection. What we are seeing, yadyapi uktam, further it is also objected actually. It is an objection of the Purvapaksha. What is the objection? Just like material, like clay, etc., they can take different forms. Similarly, pradhana also can take different forms, and because it can take different forms, it is upapatti, it is logical or tenable to hold that it is karana. Karana means it is the cause of the universe. But brahmana asahatasya, but Brahman, which is alone or without any combination, without any companion, tat pradhanasya ashabdatvayanena pratyuktam. Brahmana iti. So up to this it is objection. But because Brahman is without any other thing, it is alone, it is non-dual, so it cannot be the cause of universe. So if we were to object, of if there were an objection that just like clay, etc., pradhana can take various forms, and so it can be called as the cause of the universe, it is quite logical. But Brahman cannot take form, so it is not cause of the universe. If we were to say like that, iti means here logic, this objection ends, then tat pradhanasya ashabdatvenaiva pratyuktam. Then pratyuktam, we counter that objection by saying that tat pradhanasya ashabdatvenaiva, that pradhana which you are telling is the cause of the universe is ashabda, means it is not supported by the scriptures, by the shruti, by shabda. So the scriptures don't say, or the shruti does not say, that pradhana is the cause of this universe. So we don't accept. Yathatu tarkena api brahmana eva karanatvam nirvodum shakyate na pradhanadinam yatha tatha prapancha yishyati na vilakshanatvat asya iti evam adina. Also yathatu tarkena api, even by logic, brahmana eva karanatvam nirvodum shakyate, we can only say that only Brahman is the cause of this universe, na pradhanadinam. We cannot hold that pradhana, etc., means other things, pradhana, prakriti or whatever, is the cause of the universe. And this method, how we have come to this conclusion, that we are explaining in the Brahma Sutra of 2nd chapter, 1st section and 4th, 214, na vilakshanatvat adasya. Na vilakshanatvadasya. Means vilakshanatvat asya na. So this sutra, there we are going to explain why, how by logic also we are proving that pradhana is not the cause of the universe, only Brahman is. Then we now move on to the next sutra, that is the 6th sutra. So before 6th sutra, there is this introduction. Atra aha. So atra aha means this is the statement of the opponent, Purva Paksha. Yaduktam na achetanam pradhanam jagat karanam ikshitritvam ikshitritva shravanad iti. Tad anyata api upabadhyate achatena api chetanavad upachara darshanat. So here, if there is this objection by the opponent that what you have told in the just before, that pradhana, because it is achetanam, unconscious, insentient, it cannot be the cause of the universe, because shravana, or in the shruti, it is told that ikshitritva means the power of seeing has been told. Tad aikshata means it sees or it saw. So because it is told, so that is why you said that pradhana cannot be the cause of the universe, because the cause of the universe is said to have seen, and so pradhana, because it is insentient, cannot see, so it is not the cause of the universe. But tant anyatha api upapadyate, but otherwise also, the opposite also can be logical. Achetane api, though something is insentient or unconscious, chetanavat upachara darshanat, it can be treated or it can be seen as though it is conscious. How? Yatha pratyasanna patanatam nadyaha kulasya alakshya kulam pipati sati iti achetane api kule chetanavad upacharo drishtah. For example, this rivers, that when the banks of the rivers are compromised, means when water comes to the banks of the rivers, or the banks are destroyed or broken because of the rising waters of a river. So what do we say? We say that the bank is breaking. We say the bank is breaking. Okay. So if bank is breaking, pratyasanna patanatam nadyaha kulasya alakshya kulam pipatashati. So kulam pipatashati means the banks are breaking. Pratyasanna patanatam nadyaha kulasya alakshya. Alakshya, seeing, kulasya, nadyaha kulasya, the banks of river, pratyasanna patanata, which is about to fall or about to break. Seeing that, we say kulam pipatishati, that the banks of the rivers is breaking. Iti achetane api, though it is insentient or unconscious, kule chetanavad upacharah drishtah. So we drishtah, we do see in our day-to-day experience, that though the banks of a river are insentient, unconscious, but they are treated as though they are conscious. Tadvat, similarly, achetane api, even though it is insentient or unconscious, pradhane pratyasanna sarge chetanavat upacharah bhavashyati tadaikshata iti. So in pradhana, seeing it to be pratyasanna sarge, because of its being close or in proximity of sentient being or conscious being. So chetanavat upacharaha bhavishyati. It can be said that it is also treated as conscious. So pradana is in the presence of purusha, which is conscious. So pradana can be also treated consciously. It can be treated as though it is conscious. It can be treated as though it is sentient. Just like the banks of a river are treated as though they are sentient. And so it is told banks are falling. Banks cannot fall. It does not have any consciousness. So like that here also, tadaikshata iti, it saw, like that we can say. So this is the objection. Then further that objection is elaborated. Yatha loke kaschit chetanah snatva bhuktva cha aparane gramam ratena gamishyami iti ikshitva anantram tataiva niyamena pravartate tatha pradhanam mahat adi akarena niyamena pravartate. So just like yatha loke, just like in world we see, kaschit chetana, somebody who is a conscious person, means any person who is a sentient being or conscious being, snatva bhuktva cha aparane gramam ratena gamishyamiti. So having snatva, having taken a shower, bhuktva, having eaten, after bathing, or after bhuktva, having eaten food, cha aparane, in the afternoon, gramam ratena gamishyami iti, I will go to the village by a chariot. Go to a village in a chariot. Like that, somebody thinks that I will take bath, I will eat food, and then I will, in the afternoon, I will leave for the village in a chariot. Like that, ikshitva anantaram tathaiva niyamena pravartati. Like that person thinks, and then afterwards that person does in the same manner. So first that person, niyamena means in the same order that person does that work. First takes bath, then eats food, then sits on in the chariot and goes to the village. Similarly, tatha pradhanam api, similarly pradhana also, mahad adi akarena, mahat etc. There are so many 24 principles. So mahat etc. That person, that pradhana takes the form of, through the form of mahat etc. Niyamena pravartate, does the whole creation in an order. Tasmat chetanavat upacharyate, that is why it is treated as though it is conscious. Chetanavat, as if it is conscious. Why? Because it is working in a particular order. Kasmat punah karanat vihaya mukhyam ikshitritvam aupcharikam kalpyate tatteja ikshata ta apa ikshanta iti. So if the question is that kasmat puna karanat, what is the reason that you are mukhya meekshitrutvam vihaya aupacharikam kalpyate, that you are giving up the main power of seeing, like it is there in a conscious being. A conscious being can see, so you are giving up that meaning and taking the secondary meaning of aupacharikam, means secondary. Okay, secondary ikshana kartritva. So ikshana ikshitritva. So you are taking the secondary meaning of a person who makes another person see. So pradhana itself is unconscious, it is insentient. So you are saying because it is in the presence of purusha, it also can be treated as though it is conscious. So why should anybody give up the direct power of seeing and interpret this to mean indirect power of seeing, means as though somebody has given the power. Why? Like that if the question is asked. Kalpyate means you are imagining a power of seeing. Tatteja aikshata ta apa aikshanta. Chandogya Upanishad. So in the Chandogya Upanishad it said that fire saw or that water saw iti cha achetanayoho api ap tejasoho chetanavat upachara darshanat. So in the Shruti we say, this is again Purva Paksha, the Shruti we say, see that though fire and water, they are unconscious, they are insentient, but they are treated as though they are sentient. They are treated as though they are sentient, they are conscious. Tattaija, tatteja aikshata, that fire saw. Ta apa aikshanta, that water saw. So how can water and fire see? So though they are unconscious, they are treated as though they are conscious. Tasmat satkartrakam api ikshanam aupcharikam iti gamyate. Therefore, we can conclude that a person, if the person who is behind that action of seeing, if that entity is sat, that means it is always existing, if it is permanent, then the ikshanam, the act of seeing itself, can be taken as aupacharika, means it can be taken as secondary. Upachara praye vachanat iti. Why? Because it is upachara praye vachanat. Because in this statement, there are so many secondary meaning is given importance. So because secondary meaning is given importance elsewhere also in the statement or in the Shruti, so we can say here also secondary meaning only we have to take. If nowhere secondary meaning was taken, then we can say that we should take only the primary meaning. But we do see that secondary meaning is also taken, so we have to take the secondary meaning like that. Evam prapte, if this is what the Purva Paksha says, idam sutram arabhyate, then we start this sutra in reply to that Purva Paksha. In reply to that Purva Paksha, we start this sutra. That is the sixth sutra. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.